गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एक्सरसाइज 6.4 इज गोइंग ऑन. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द साइड ऑफ अ स्क्वायर हुज एरिया इज 441 मीटर स्क्वायर. इन दिस क्वेश्चन एरिया ऑफ द स्क्वायर इज गिवन एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द साइड ऑफ द स्क्वायर. स्क्वायर मीन्स ऑल साइड्स आर इक्वल. सो वी विल एज्यूम दैट साइड ऑफ द स्क्वायर इज एक्स. लेट साइड ऑफ द स्क्वायर इज एक्स मीटर. सिंस वी नो दैट एरिया ऑफ स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू साइड स्क्वायर. एरिया इज गिवन 441 एंड साइड वी हैव एज्यूम्ड दैट एक्स. सो एक्स स्क्वायर, हेयर इन द प्लेस ऑफ साइड विल राइट एक्स. एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 441. सो एक्स इज विल बी इक्वल टू, वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स साइड. एंड From left side, square will be removed. So on right side, sign of square root will be there. X equal to square root of 441 means we have to find the square root of 441. So we'll find it. We'll start making pairs from right hand side. 41 is the first pair and 4 is second pair. 2 twos are 4. We'll read the table in squares. 2 twos are 4. 4 minus 4 is 0 and here whole pair will be down. 41 and here we will add these two numbers. 2 plus 2 is 4. Now we'll read the table of 4 such that the same number will be here also, there also. 41 ones are 41. 41 minus 41 is 0. So square root of 441 is 21, means x equal to 21. What was x? Side of the square. Therefore side of the square is 21 meter. Now next question, question number 7. In our triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree. First part I am taking, AB is given 6 centimeter, BC is given 8 centimeter. You have to find AC. First of all, we will draw one triangle in which angle B is 90 degree. It means it is a right triangle. One angle is 90 degree. It means it is a right triangle. AB is given 6 cm, BC is given 8 cm and we have to find AC. Let AC is X. We know that in right triangle by Pythagoras theorem, perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. It is perpendicular square plus base square is equal to hypotenuse square. Perpendicular is AB, so we'll write AB square. And base is BC plus BC square is equal to hypotenuse is AC, is equal to AC square. Now we'll put the values of AB and BC. AB is 6, so it will be 6 square. BC is 8 plus 8 square, 6 square plus 8 square is equal to AC is X square. Now we'll solve it. 6 square is 36 and 8 square is 64. 36 plus 64 is equal to x square. 36 plus 64 is equal to 100. 100 equal to x square. X square is equal to 100 means x means square root of 100. Square root of 100 is 10 tens are, because it is a 10 square, so square root of 100 is 10. X is equal to 10 means AC is equal to 10 centimeter. Now question number 8. A gardener has 1000 plants. He wants to plant these in such a way that number of rows and the number of columns remain same. Find the minimum number of plants he needs more for this. See here, number of plants are 1000. Since number of rows equal to number of columns, suppose there are 10 rows, so there will be 10 columns. So total plants will be 10 into 10 is equal to 100. Means number of plants should be a perfect square. Number of plants should be perfect square. Here 1000 is not a perfect square. So first of all, we'll find its square root. 1000 square root we are finding. So first of all, we'll make pairs. We'll read the table in squares. 3 threes are 9. 10 minus 9 is 1 and this pair of zeros will be down. 3 plus 3 6. Then 61 ones are 61. 10 minus 1 is 9, and here 9 minus 6 is 3. Remainder is there, it means it is not a perfect square. So now they are asking how many more plants. It means we have to make it a perfect square by adding something to 1000. Now see, 31, this number is 31. So next number of 31 is 32. So we will find 32 square. 32 square is 1024. So means we have to make 1000 to 1024. So something will be added in this. What should be added in 1000 to make it a perfect square? 1024 minus 1000 is equal to 24. So 24 will be added in 1000 to make it perfect square. 24 should be added in 1000 to make it a perfect square. It means he needs 24 more plants for this purpose. Now question number 9. There are 500 children in a school. For a PT drill, they have to stand in such a manner that the number of rows is equal to the number of columns. How many children would be left out in this arrangement? Again, number of rows is equal to number of columns. So number of children should be a perfect square. Here number of children is given 500, but 500 is not a perfect square. Since number of rows equal to number of columns, so number of children should be a perfect square. Now let's see, first of all we'll find its square root. 500, start making pairs from right hand side. 0 first pair and 5 is second pair. We'll read the table in 5 in squares. 2 2's are 4. 5 minus 4 is 1. Here 2 plus 2 is 4. And this pair of zeros will be down. Now we'll read the table of 4 in such a way that 42 into 2 is equal to 84. Suppose we are taking 3, so 43 into 3 will be greater. So 42 into 2 is 84. Now we'll subtract. 10 minus 4 is 6. 9 minus 8 is 1. So they are asking how many children would be left out in this arrangement. So remainder is 16. So 16 children, if we will subtract from this, 16 should be subtracted from 500 to make it a perfect square. Number of children should be in perfect square, so 16 will be subtracted from 500 to make it a perfect square. 500 minus 16 is equal to 484. This should be the number of children for this arrangement. Means 16 children should be left out in this arrangement. Whatever is the remainder, that many children will be left out. Now children, be part of question number 7. You have to do yourself. Here ends our chapter number 6.